Christmas, everybody. How are you doing here at Joplin Gardens? We have a sold-out crowd. Look all around. Everybody's here on Christmas morning to enjoy some music, I hope. I'm Bob Durham, and guess what I play? Who knows what I play?
Piano.
And believe it or not, I'm going to sing a little bit today. Okay, so don't get scared by my singing, but I brought the best singer in the Joplin, Missouri area, Mike Greenstreet, I'll bring on in a little bit. But it's really good to see you, and guess what? We're going to give you a chance to sing as well. And we're doing something special today for our friends on the internet that's tuning in to watch the Christmas show. So thanks for tuning in and watching the Bob and Mike Christmas show. I'm going to start out with some songs, and then you will talk about them, and you tell me if you recognize any of these great Christmas songs.
Thank you.
recognize any of those Christmas carols? All of them? Well, good. I started with a medley with Joy to the World, and then we had O Holy Night, O Come All Ye Faithful, Hark There Our Herald Angels Sing, and I even put Handel's Messiah, the Hallelujah Chorus there, and everybody clapped loud after that, you know? When Handel's Hallelujah Chorus came out, people would always stand, but you clap loud, so I'm not going to hold that against you that you didn't stand. But we also played We Three Kings with Carol the Bells, all great songs of Jesus' birth, which is the reason for Christmas. But we're going to take a little detour and do some songs about Santa and snow and some of those fun carols that you always hear at Christmas time. And I want to start with one. It's too warm today for snow. And if Frosty the Snowman peeked in our window, he would not be doing too well. He would be melting, correct?
Yeah.
So let's just send Frosty, maybe, you know, since it's such a pleasant day, let's send him to the Caribbean beaches and see how he would do there. Well, the reason I call it that is this style is kind of in a Caribbean style. I made this up one day because my mom's old sheet music of Frosty the Snowman, I was tired of playing it like it's written. That's okay, but I wanted something different. So let's send Frosty to the beach in the Caribbean, okay? Michael Bublé and his Christmas show. Here's Silver Bells, and I dedicate this to my friend Roy. He loves this song.
Silver bells,
Okay. Did anybody try singing along on that? I didn't hear anybody. But I definitely want you to sing along now, okay? Because we're going to sing together on Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Had a very shiny nose, everybody. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. Look like all of the other reindeer. I used to laugh and call him names like Bozo. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Washington, like Columbus, all those people. Would you sing? He did it last night. It's kind of a day late to be singing this, but let's sing. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blitzen and all his reindeer are pulling on the rain. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers. Getting off on a technicality. It's still a Christmas song. Here comes Santa Claus. Speaking of good singing, I brought my friend Mike Greenstreet along. Now, this is how you know it's Mike Greenstreet. He is wearing his green jacket. When he doesn't wear his green jacket, it's harder to know who he is. But just once in his life, I've known him since I was a little tiny kid, I want him to move to Greenstreet. So Mike Greenstreet can live on Greenstreet. I just want him to build his own house and start his own neighborhood and call it Greenstreet. You've been working on that, Mike?
I'm working on it.
He's working on it.
Not real hard, though.
And we've got some soundtracks with us today, and I'll tell you about some of these after a while. But we're going to sing Jingle Bells, and we're going to need you to help. Okay, Mike? Are you going to actually be playing your sleigh bells?
I've learned a new instrument since I was here last.
You have. I've heard that about you. Don't injure yourself when you play it.
Multi-talented.
He's got his sleigh bells, and we got Kevin Williams on guitar. He's a much better guitarist than Mike. So we got Kevin on guitar, and then I'm on piano. Did you notice I'm on piano?
Yeah.
I'm on piano, everybody. Okay. Let's start it, Mike. We're experiencing some technical difficulties.
All right, here we go.
By my side, the horse was leading way. This horse Bells. Did you know Jingle Bells was written for a Thanksgiving church service? It was in the snowy part of the country, and I think it was up in New Hampshire or somewhere, and they were having a Thanksgiving program, and that's how it got started. But anyway, we wanted to have special guests besides Mike and myself. We called Willie Nelson. He was unable to come, but it doesn't matter. Mike sings this old Willie Nelson song better than he does anyway.
Pretty papers.
Oh, that's the nasal version.
Pretty papers, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencil to write, I love you. Pretty papers, pretty ribbons of blue. Around the street, busy feet hustle by him. Downtown shopper, say Christmas is nigh. There he sits, all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass by. Should I stop? Better not. Much too busy. You're in a hurry. Pretty paper, pretty ribbon of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you.
Christmas are always in pretty paper. They're in prettier paper than birthday presents and all those type of things. And it makes me think, you know, I've had, this is my 59th Christmas. The first one I was only 9 months old. And I can have a lot of memories of favorite Christmas presents. You've all had more Christmases than I have. I might be the youngest one in this circle, and a lot of these workers are younger. But Mike's had a lot more Christmases than me, too. But let's talk about some of our favorite Christmas presents. I was probably 12. And what I liked as a 12-year-old was those little Hot Wheel cars. Did you ever see those? And we would set up a track. I would hook up to my mom's step stool from the kitchen, the top, and then they would shoot down the chute, and there was a finish line, and it, you can know which one won left or right based on the flag that went down. And I loved that, and I had a lot of Hot Wheels, but one year they came out with Sizzlers. They were Sizzlers Hot Wheels. You plugged in a plug into them and charged them, and they went all by themselves. And this Christmas, I got the fat track, the wide track that they were on, and they didn't stay in their little lanes. They would go all over that track racing, and it was so exciting. When one would run out of energy, you would charge it in the little charger that looked like a gas pump. and you get it back out on the track and you're racing. It was always fun to go against somebody because then you're, and there was a lap counter that counted how many times they went around Mike. It was a ball. And to top it off, my parents said, now Christmas isn't over yet. There's a big present behind the tree. That's for you and your brother, who was 10 years older than I. Mike, we got a pool table. That was my best Christmas as a kid. The Sizzler's track and the pool table. Now you're going to have a hard time topping it. Tell us about one of your favorite Christmases.
He was one of the rich kids.
Yeah, apparently.
I'm just a couple of days older than Bob. But back when I was a little boy, and this would have been probably in the late 50s, I guess, somewhere along in there. I was born in 46. They came out from Japan with them little bitty transistor radios. Remember those? They were about like that. A little bit bigger than a package of cigarettes. So that's what I wanted for Christmas, because all the cool kids had one of those. And they had them for like $6.95, and then you could get the deluxe one for $8.95. And I told my mom and dad that's what I wanted. And my dad done a lot of shopping at Montgomery Ward's. He called it Monkey Ward's. So Christmas came, Christmas Eve. We always opened our presents on Christmas Eve. And I was so excited because I was sure I was going to get that little bitty transistor ready to fit right down in my pocket. Man, when I'd walk into school, I'd be one of the cool kids.
Cool dude.
Christmas Eve come, and I seen my present under the tree, and it was a box about this big, by about that big, by about that big. And I thought, well, now they're trying to trick me. They're trying to fool me. They put that little bitty radio in that big old box. And I thought, they're not going to fool me. I know what's in there. So my turn to open the presents, and so I started tearing into it, and front of the box, it had a picture of a transistor radio, but it looked pretty big.
Uh-oh.
It looked really big. It said airline, so it came from Montgomery Ward's on it. And so I tore it up a little bit more, and it looked to me like it was about like that. And I thought, well, wait a minute, now that ain't the little one I was wanting with a little thing that you plugged in your ear. And so I got it open, and you'd have to know my dad to appreciate this, but we weren't rich by no means, but he always bought the best that he could afford. So when he went down to Montgomery Ward's and was talking to the salesperson to get me that little transistor radio, they talked him into buying this one that was this big by that big by that big.
The first boombox, huh?
The first boombox. And I'm thinking, well, you know, I was a little disappointed because, you know, I'm thinking I'm going to have to get my little red wagon to carry that thing to school. But anyway, it was really a nice one, and boy, did it sound good. And my dad used it more than I did because he liked to listen to the Grand Ole Opry on nice. Saturday night, and he would take my transistor radio and listen to the Grand Ole Opry.
What you need to do is you need to think of some of your favorite Christmas presents as a child, and when we say goodbye to you after a while, you can tell us some of those, okay? And like I said, Willie couldn't be here, and we wanted a special guest to come, but Elvis can't be here today either. He had to get another gig. But anyway, Mike's going to sing the old Elvis Presley Christmas song.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so good thinking all about you. You'll be decorations of friends.
Build a snowman, and pretend that
Days of praise, the plans that we made, walking in the wonderland, walking in the winter wonderland.
I knew that one.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening?
I knew that one. I've been singing with you all this time. And God bless you. The Lord is number one, forever and ever.
Bob, that's enough of the sleigh bells, okay?
Oh, enough of the sleigh bells, okay.
No, sir.
Well, enough's enough, Mike. Why don't you take a seat?
I'm going to sit.
Now, the rest of the program, we're going to all enjoy some songs of our Savior's birth. And this song, I've actually been playing since high school. It's kind of a boogie-woogie jazz style. And see if you recognize this old spiritual. Somebody's ringing the doorbell.
Thank you.
all sing along with me on some carols, okay? And these are wonderful songs of Jesus' birth. Let's sing the first song. Sing a verse that you may not know, but I follow a man on YouTube named Mark Lowry, and he's known for his comedy, and he follows some of the Christian artists and tour, and has always done a lot of comedy. Well, during the pandemic, he went live from his bedroom every day just to encourage people and singing hymns, the old hymns of the church. Well, he's not a musician, but he's a really good singer. But he was fussing because he's funny. I'll start one key and end in another key. I need a pianist. Well, I don't have a room for a piano in here. I need a guitarist. Well, then he got the idea of calling his friend Kevin Williams on the phone. Kevin plays guitar. We heard his music a while ago when I made Mike quit playing guitar. But he is a great guitarist. And he tours with the Gaithers and the vocal band. Mark used to sing with the Gaither vocal band. So now Mark has recorded albums of these hymns, and he so people can hear them and sing along. It's called Sit Up Straight and Sing. And we played some for you the last time we were here, and you were singing along. He said, one of the things he said was, we want you to take this music and sing along where you're in church. He said, take it to the nursing homes and let them sing along. So I'm like, that's what I'm gonna do. Take it to the nursing homes. I got it in October, the day before we did our first nursing home gig in October. So we were immediately doing Mark Lowry's sing-along songs. So on this one, I'm going to play the recording and let Mark Lowry lead you in It Came Upon the Midnight Clear. Okay, Mike?
Ready?
Yep. Let's sing it, everybody.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels standing near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all-gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing.
Now let's sing this other verse.
And
Christmas, and it's become one of the most popular Christmas songs all over the world. You know, it's a standard now, and it was 30 years ago this Christmas he wrote the lyric, in 1984 actually, and he, because he's not a musician, he looked around for people to set a tune to it, and 7 years later Buddy Green set the tune to this song, Mary Did You Know, and I'm going to play my rendition of it that I've taken from an arrangement by Anthony Berger.
Thank you.
great song. Mike's going to come back up and finish the show with us today. And we're going to sing another song that you're going to know. And I'm going to get Kevin Williams playing guitar again. And you sing along with us on this one. Songs. Now, quartets would tour the country taking these songbooks and selling them to churches and anybody that would buy them. They would have singing conventions and in the summer set up the big tent or go in a big church and they would teach them these songs and then the people would buy the songbooks. Well, this first appeared in one of those old Stamps Baxter songbooks and people realized, hey, that's a good song for Christmas. So it became popular by bluegrass artists, country gospel artists, and some southern gospel artists, but it's also popular by Joplin, Missouri's own My Green Street. He's going to sing for you one of my favorite songs for Christmas, Beautiful Star of Bethlehem. Sing it if you know it.
Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining forth through shadows dim, giving the light for those who long.
Saying, where is he that is born the King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, and thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when all he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search diligently for this young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary and his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasure, they presented him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. Even the gifts the wise men brought the baby Jesus was foretelling his future. The frankincense and myrrh were perfumes and spices of burial, because Jesus would die for us on the cross and be buried and raised again for that we may have salvation and eternal life. And we hope that you celebrate that version of Christmas right there. And let's sing a great song to close, and we'll get you singing on it if you know it. I bet you did. Maybe a Valentine show. You all know my daddy was a resident here. Some of you may not know that, but Christmas season of 2016 is when I started playing the piano here, and it was a Christmas Eve. I went back into his room after we were done, and daddy was in poor health. He was 89, and I said to daddy, I said, "You know, daddy, did you like the Christmas music here?" He sat right here. We had a chair right here for him, and he said, "Yeah, I liked it. It was great." And I said, "Well, you're not going to be with us maybe too many more Christmases. What would you think if I kept coming out here and playing music at Christmas for the residents?" And he's like, "I don't care what you do. I'll be in heaven." So daddy's in heaven, and we hope you got to enjoy the music.